up, you guys? FSC Trucking. I just got done loading this Oshkosh 6x6 crane truck. Got Orwell behind me. Orwell is the real star of the show. Orwell, as you know, is my 1984 Peterbilt 362 cab over. And we just got done loading, as you've seen in the previous video. If you see the previous video, check it out. That truck doesn't run. We had to get a wrecker to come out here and get it done for us. So we backed it up on there, we tied it down. Let me show you how we did it, because it got a little complicated. I thought tying down would be relatively easy because we have these tie down hooks right here, but the truck is so long it sticks off the back of the trailer a little bit. By the way, it's a 50-foot trailer, so you can overhang 3 feet or not even close, so we're golden there. The other reason I wanted it so far back is because this being a 6x6, there's a lot of weight in the front, but I'll get ahead and show you that in a minute. So what I wound up doing was I wound up grabbing the frame right at the tail end of it and crossing over to my stake pockets there and here, pulling them forward. This way these chains pull the truck that way. On the front, we had multiple ways we could have done it on the front axle, but I decided to go with the behind the rear axle. You could do it that way, but you have to watch your clearance on your center link there. That's that bar that works your steering. As long as you're not hitting that, you're fine. There's no hoses or tubes around that diff, so I was able to grab it that way. That holds the truck pulling it backwards. Also, if I hit the brake, these are the chains to stop the truck from rolling into the top deck. I could have brought the truck forward more a little bit, close that gap, but you got your engine in there, a whole differential, and it is not a light duty one. Also, the way these trucks work is all the transmission torque comes from the transmission up here, goes to the drive shaft into this transfer case, and the transfer case is what sends the power to the rear diffs and the front diffs. And I imagine that hose right there, this one right here, or rather that's an electric actuator, I imagine that's how they disconnect the forward drive shaft from the transfer case. That way it'll run unlocked. So when they towed it here, they disconnected the drive shaft from the rear ends and tied the drive shaft up. That's why that drive shaft is up at a slight angle. It's tied up to the frame. So yeah, that's the drive wheels, two tag axles, big ol' Oshkosh. I forget the model number, but it is an Oshkosh truck. It's more of the civilian side, big heavy duty industrial stuff. It's been sitting around a little bit. A lot of growth where the water drips down. Oh, the other side is tied down, but I didn't tie this side. Two videos ago from Alabama, we had a hood open on us when I came to a stop. Want to hit the brake. There we go. Alrighty. So yeah, there we go. Oshkosh broom. Broom. There we go. Our Oshkosh crane truck. Alrighty, boys and girls, here we go. That's our Oshkosh crane truck. Let's go ahead and get in Orwell. Let's go figure out how to get out of here, weigh it, see where we sit, and get on down the line. Bondewell, Wisconsin, here we go. Thank you. 10 minutes away. Let me go over there, weigh it, and I'll probably sit there, edit video, try to figure out what I want to do, and then go from there. Leave today or leave tomorrow, don't really matter. I guess we'll see how long it takes me to get my editing done. Oh yeah, that's right, if you go that way, you can't make a left. Dead end road. Island, and when you come out the way you came in, you can't make a left and continue. You have to go the way you came from, and we don't want to go the way we came from. We want to head south. So hence the concern. This road doesn't look like a truck-friendly road, but there's no sign saying you can't. I'm probably over-worrying, but that's all right. White sign say this one's a weight limit of 13 tons that way, but where? Okay, don't tell me how far down the road, whatever you do. All I'm trying to do is get the friggin' Route 1. Okay, Move this way. Can't make this shit up.
Oh no.
Yeah, I better go around. I gotta love this madness. Watch that black car go up over that railroad grade. This trailer bottom out. If I was empty, I would just gun it and drag it right across, but high center it and bottom and get stuck. Then what? Doing, don't you? One red car just like, I'm gonna pull in behind you and I'm gonna make you wait. Let's see how well that worked out for him. do is get from here to Route 1. Somebody put a damned stupid bridge there. Street we came on, you go straight, get to that major road up there.
Castle.
I guess they got a truck stop too. I gotta get fuel anyway. If I'm gonna get fuel, I'd rather get it at Wawa. So that Raceway had diesel for under $4, but they don't have truck pumps or even tank comm data, so. Alrighty, so it normally take comm data, but it didn't work on the fleet side. Mr. Fleet thing is broke. So, we're assed out on that one. So off to the pilot. Thank you. truck, GPS incorrect, no truck access to route 10. Follow so-and-so to route 10. Just saw with a flashing light over. What a damn nightmare. $7.11 is $4.15 a gallon. $4.55 a gallon at the Pilot. Scale.